Hey guys, welcome to Math Class with Ms. Brown. Before we get started with today's lesson, make sure you guys subscribe to this channel for more fun math videos. And make sure you guys like this video and share it with your family and friends. Now let's get started with today's lesson. In today's class, you guys are going to learn how to divide using the box method. And you have your criteria for success, and it says, create a box. Then section the box using vertical lines dependent on how many digits your dividend has. Then it says place your divisor outside of the box. Then it says ask yourself, is your divisor times a number? Will it get you close to the number in each section in the box? Whatever the answer is, put it at the top of the box, then multiply, bring down, subtract, bring up, and then repeat. I know that's a lot. That is a lot. It is a lot to digest right now, but we are going to jump into today's lesson and we are going to get started. Let's go. So our first problem is 34 divided by 5. We need to create a box, and we already have one right there. And then next it says to section the box using vertical lines depending on how many digits your dividend has. So as you can see, the first number inside of a division sentence is called your dividend, right? And as you can see, it is 34, and that is two digits, right? So we are going to go ahead and place our 34 inside of our box. Make sure the numbers are spread out, and you want to leave space in between so we can put that line, right? Okay, so we have that nice and even. Then it says place your divisor outside of the box. The divisor is always the second number in your division sentence. And then we're going to place that divisor right outside of the box, okay? Just like that, our divisor is 5, we place it outside of the box. Then it says, ask yourself, your divisor times what number will get you close to the number in each section in the box. I know that sounds a little confusing, but as we do it, it will be much more clear, okay? So, we ask ourselves, 5, which is our divisor, 5 times a number, right, that will get me close to 3, because 3 is our first digit inside of the section, right? So ask yourself, 5 times what number will get me close to 3, right? So we could say, well, 5 times 1, right? We could say, well, 5 times 1 will get me close to 3, right? But 5 times 1 is 5, right? And 5 is close to 3. But whatever number we put inside of that blank, when we multiply it, we don't want it to be higher than our total that we see there, which is 3. So we would say 5 times 0 will get us close to 3. We can't go over 3, right? So we'll place that 0 at the top, okay? And then now we have to multiply. We multiply, okay? So as you guys can see, whatever the answer we got, which was 0, you place it at the top of the box, okay? We did that. And then next we multiply. So we're going to take that 0 that's at the top, and we're going to multiply it by our divisor. Okay, are you guys following along? Okay, 0 times 5 is 0. So then we bring down the 0, which we just did, right? And then we need to subtract. Now we're going to subtract. 3 minus 0 is 3. We have that. Now we're going to bring up. We're going to bring that 3 up. The 3 is going to go before the digit that's there, right? That's why we need space before that digit, because of this reason. Now we're going to repeat. Now our next number is 34. So now we're going to take our divisor, 5, right? Ask yourself, our divisor times what number will get us close to the number in that section, right? So 5 times a number that will get us close to 34. Think about it. 5 times what number will get us close to 34, right? So let's think about that. So what do you guys think? 5 times 6. Right? 5 times 6. Yeah, because 5 times 6 is 30, and it's not higher. 30 is not bigger than 34. So yeah, we're going to take that 6, and we are going to put it here at the top. And 6 times 5 is, we have to multiply now. 6 times 5 is 30, right? So now we have to what? Yep, we have to subtract. So 34 minus 30 is 4. So that 4 that we have left, we can bring it up, but what are we bringing it up to? There's no other place besides there. So that is just going to be our remainder. So we are going to take our whole number, right, which is 6, and we have 6 remainder 4 as our answer. And there you go. There you have it. I know this is a lot. It's a lot of steps, but don't worry. We are going to try another one. Okay, so here is another one. Now, this one we have 278 divided by 3. But remember, before we had a 2-digit by a 1-digit. Now, this one is a 3-digit by a 2-digit. 3-digit by a 1-digit, I'm sorry. So we created our box. So now we need to section off the box using vertical lines depending on how many digits our dividend has. And our dividend has 3 digits, 278. So I'm going to put the 2, the 7, and the 8. So now I'm going to section it off by drawing my vertical lines. And remember, make sure that you have a lot of space in between each number because that's very important. All right? It's very important for when you bring those numbers up and you just don't want your work to look cluttered and disorganized, right? So next it says place your divisor outside of your box. And our divisor is 3, right? Our divisor is 3, right? So we're going to place that right outside of the box right here. We have the number 3 there. Perfect, perfect, perfect. So now we have to ask ourselves, your divisor times what number will get you close to the number in each section of the box, right? So our first number is 2. We have 2, 7, 8. Our first number is 2. So our divisor is 3. So now we're going to go ahead and start with our equation. So we have 3, which is our divisor, 3 times what number would get us close to, what is our first digit? 2, right? 3 times what would get us closer to? Think about it. Think about it. 3 times what? 3 times what? Okay, let's say 0. Yes, 3 times 0 gets us close, the closest to 2. So we're going to bring our 0 up. Then next we need to, right? We put our number at the top of the box and then we need to what? What do we need to do next? Multiply. Yes, awesome. We need to multiply, right? So then we're going to multiply 0 times 3 is 0. Bring that 0 down, right? We brought it down. Then we subtract. 2 minus 0 is 2. Then we what? After we subtract, we what? Bring up. We bring that 2 up. The number that you bring up always have to go in front of the digit that was already there. So now we have 27 in the next section. So now we're going to repeat the process all over again. So 3 times what number gets us close to 27? Or 3 times what number will give us 27, right? And you guys should know this, right? 9, yes. 3 times 9 doesn't get us close to 27. 3 times 9 is 27. Yes. So we're going to put our 9 up there. And then now we are going to multiply, right? All right, 9 times 3 is 27, right? Now we are going to subtract. 27 minus 27 is 0. Okay, what do we do with that 0? Yep, bring it up. Bring that 0 up. Bring it up. Bring it up. But guess what? We brought the 0 up and it goes before the digit that was already there, but that's still 8. That still reads 8, right? So 3 times what number will get us close to 8, right? And you don't have to write the 0 down here. You could just put the 8 because it's still 8, right? So 3 times what number get us close to 8? Yep, 3 times 2 because 3 times 2 is 6 and 6 is close to 2. So 2 times 3 is 6, right? Now we're going to subtract. 8 minus 6 is 2. We can't bring that 2 up nowhere, so the 2 is going to be our what? What is it going to be? Yes, our remainder. So our answer is going to be our whole number, which is at the top of the box, 92. So our answer is going to be 92, right? Let's write it over here, 92. And now what do we have left? Remainder 2. So that is our final answer. Yes. You guys are getting better. You're getting better. So now let's go ahead and move on to another one. Whoa, okay. So we have 515 divided by 11, right? But before I get started on this, I want you guys to pause this video, go get a paper and pencil, and try this on your own. Try it on your own. You got this. And when you're done, we're going to come back together and then we are going to go over it, okay? Okay, you guys should be done. So let's create our box, right? We have a box there already. So now let's section the box using vertical lines depending on how many digits our dividend has, right? So our dividend, right, is always the first number and we have 515. So how many digits do you see? We see 3, right? So I'm going to just go ahead and write it over here. 5, 1, 5. As you guys can see, I left space, tons of space between each digit, which is very important. So now I'm going to put my vertical lines, make sure that there's space, okay? So now I'm going to place my divisor outside of the box. And my divisor this time is a two-digit number. Before, we were working with a one-digit number, a one-digit divisor. But now we have a two-digit divisor. Oh my God. Let's see what's going to happen. So we place our divisor outside, which is 11, right? So now we are going to ask ourselves, our divisor times what number will get us close to the number inside of each section, right? So let's just follow the steps. Let's get to it. So 11 times what number will get us close to 5, because 5 is our first digit, right? So think about that. What number times 11 will get us close to 5? 0. Yep. So we're going to put 0 at the top. Right at the top of the box, what we just did, yes, and then we are going to multiply, right? 0 times 11 is 0, yes. So now we are going to subtract, right? We brought the 0 down, now we're going to subtract, bring that up. So we're going to bring that 5 up, right? Bring it up. Remember, it always goes before the number that was already there. So now our new number inside of that section is 51. And then we're going to repeat the process. So 11 times what number will get us close to 51. Think about that. Think about your multiples of 11, right? What number times 11 will get us close to 51? Yep, the answer is 4. 4, 4, 4. So 4 times 11 is 44, right? So we're going to put our 4 up there, right? We're going to put 4 up there. Let's fix that. Let's fix the 4, make it nice and neat, right? So, yeah, so we have a 4 up there, so we're going to multiply. 4 times 11, like we said, is 44. So now we have to subtract. But see, with this, we see that in this section right here, we have to regroup. We have to subtract. So we can't do 1 minus 4. We're going to borrow from the 5 and add that 1 to the ones place. So 11 minus 4 is 7, right? And then 4 minus 4 is 0. So that still reads 7, right? So we're going to bring that 7 up, put it before the digit that was there already. So now in this section, we have a new number of 75. And now we're going to repeat the process. So 11 times what number is going to get us close to 75? Think about it. 11 times what number is going to get us close to 75? Yep, 6. 666, right? Because 11 times 6 is 66, and we can't go over the 75. So put our 6 up. Let's fix that. I don't know what is going on. All right, so there we go. So we're going to put 6 right there. So 6 times 11 is 66. There we go. Oops, in this section, we have to subtract, and I see we got to regroup. Borrow from the 7, turn that to the 6, make that into a 15. 15 minus 6 is 9. That 9 can't go anywhere. So guess what? That's going to be our what? You guessed it right. So we have a whole number of 46 with a remainder of 9. And there you go. Did you guys get this right? All right. But if you didn't get it right, it is okay. Like I always tell you, the more practice, the better you will become. All right? So don't stress yourself out. You guys got this. You did an amazing job. Okay, that's the end of today's lesson. You guys did amazing. Remember, it's going to take more practice. But before you go, make sure you subscribe to this channel, like this video, and share this video with your classmates and your family and friends if they need help in math. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram at Miss Brown_the_math_teacher and on TikTok at Miss Brown the math teacher. I'll see you guys in the next class. Bye.